the problem stems from the tolerance of corruption. Okay, so hear me out here. What I'm saying is that if this administration really had a zero tolerance of corruption, then those who've been already fired or found guilty by a Senate hearing or incarcerated after an investigation should be out of government service. But the problem, Sito, is that government officials who are friends of the president or friends of Malacanang, okay, after having been found guilty of abuse of funds and corruption, are recycled in other departments. And I can name you the names. I mean, I have the list here. And so, and that's the, for me, that's the crux of the problem. If Malacanang itself does not find anything wrong with people abusing public funds and still, you know, takes them out for show because of public pressure and recycles them into another. It's just a vicious cycle of corruption over and over again. Oh, by the way, the Pastillas person is back in office, huh?
Huh?
The Pastillas person is back in office. I can tell you his name, but I'd rather not. But
let's do that off air.
But yeah, but he was taken off and recycled. Guess where? Bureau of Customs again. So, ano ba to? Is this a fluke or what? So, my feeling is this whole narrative of the Duterte administration,